The Nigeria Labour Congress, NLC, is rejecting plans by the federal government to increase taxes on non-alcoholic and carbonated drinks. NLC believes implementing increased taxes on non-alcoholic and carbonated drinks, which is one of the provisions in the 2021 Finance Act, will impose more hardship on the citizens. The government had announced the increased taxes as a way of discouraging overconsumption of sugar, checking obesity, and also generating more money to fund the 2022 budget. The NLC therefore asked the National Assembly to urgently amend the sections of the Finance Act which reintroduce excise duties on non-alcoholic and carbonated drinks. We are now joined by Comrade Amaechi Osuguni, NLC Deputy President. Good evening, Mr. Osuguni.
Good evening, madam. Thank you.
Well, the organized labor says the federal government's imposition of excise duties on locally produced non-alcoholic, carbonated and sugary drinks is nothing but a declaration of war on Nigerians. How do you respond to that?
I think NSC is strongly frowned at the proposal to impose a duty on carbonated drinks. The question is looking at the timing we are and the reasons being canvassed around the exercise is very, very premature, because we're talking about a product that has created massive employment for Nigerians. We're talking about a sector that has accommodated and promoted manufacturers existing in Nigeria. So we shouldn't also impose a threat to the manufacturers that eventually leave Nigeria and they will begin to import these goods, so that we don't begin to suspect there are people that are bringing these awkward ideas, discouraging production that are already taking place in the country, and whereby this happens. You know, the same thing like we earlier mentioned in the press release by the NSC president. The same thing happened to Michelin and Dunlop, the tire companies that folded up and they relocated to Ghana. And they are doing well, and we're still importing those goods today. So anytime we want to talk about increase or moderation, look at the reason canvas over sugar. The product is not coming today. These are average drinks that almost all families in Nigeria take. Look at the artisans. Some of them, they take a soft drink and they're possibly little thin snacks to chew in the afternoon, and it becomes their lunch. And they go about doing the business that is keeping them off crime. So anytime you attempt to raise increase on product like this, the same Nigerians will indulge in substandard carbonated drinks that will be more hazardous than what you think to prevent.
Well,
the use of orientation is better served than this idea.
Comrade Asuguni, yes, some Nigerians may argue that, well, Nigerians have alternatives, which some would say are even probably healthier, like Zobo, Kunu, etc. How do you react to that?
Those are alternatives that exist already. The question is, what economic benefit are we going to get? Government saying they need more money, and the action they are taking will hinder their revenue. So you begin to wonder what is behind it. Because by the time you raise excise duty on this very item, production of those drinks will drop. Consumption certainly will drop, and it will affect production. And when that happens, downsizing of workforce will set in. They're going to remove workers. And then the same people that are paying already added value tax, they are paying VAT already. So now they are going to drop VAT on whatever consumption they're already giving out. And that will affect revenue for government. So the idea that they want to use it to generate revenue is already counterproductive. And the idea that they want to solve the problem of health for Nigeria, it becomes laughable, because the product that are hazardous to Nigeria youth, you see people smoking India hemp all over. They are finding some of this product around this country. And government have not raised some policy to erase. There is another one, they call Burumili or something. And you see people consuming these dangerous drinks or smokes. Look at the tobacco that we see every day. Has the policy on tobacco changed the consumption? So the idea that if you add 10 naira on a liter of a carbonated drink, it will now reduce intake of sugar. That is false, because carbon dioxide alone constitutes more sugar to every living being. How many people are even drinking mineral? How many people are taking soft drink? But people eat it by eat rice every day in this country.
Okay, tell us.
Are we going to get to a point where we're going to now impose tax again on day-to-day item we consume?
Okay, let's look at...
We should know our limit.
Let's look at the NLC's request to the National Assembly to urgently amend the sections of the Finance Act which reintroduce the excise duties on non-alcoholic and carbonated drinks. Tell us more about it.
NLC is of the opinion that it should be amended because it's already injurious to both the government fund and the workers of Nigeria. Anything that imposes high cost of living to workers' salary that we're already saying is not enough is going to endanger agitation, because Nigerians are the people National Assembly represent. It's unfortunate that they signed it into law before this time. And I think a more proactive approach will be engaged by Congress in such a way that before any bill is processed, an officer assigned to National Assembly will have reported, because some of this is, we don't need to allow them in. Because if we're talking about health, and do you know that it's more health challenging for a worker to suffer hungry? Because some of these things we call, you just commonize them unknowingly to you that this is how people mitigate the hazardous challenge of a low salary in the country. So we believe the National Assembly should do a reverse on that very article. I think it was an oversight for National Assembly to have indulged in this idea of imposing tax on something that we produce here. If we're talking about tariff now, we're talking about custom duties, for importation, more or less taxes that are imposed on imported goods, then we know that Nigerian government is discouraging importation and encouraging manufacturers to locally produce.
Okay.
Whereby you discourage the few we have now, it's going to be dangerous.
Well, comrade,
a country can never seem to grow without you promoting your local product.
Comrade, you're very passionate about this, as most of comrades are about issues. Do we expect any kind of protests in future should the government go ahead with this?
So this is one among other pressing issues that we're already pushing. So if government continue to now launch policies at the beginning of the year that is going to, in return, filter negative to Nigerian workers, certainly NSC will convey its organ meeting to review. But as I speak with you, there is already an approved mandate to NSC to resist the proposed increase on PMS. So if this is going to be added to it, there is going to be a multi-action, because I know NSC will stop at nothing in resisting any policy that will be anti-people. And this is one of them we see.
Well, thank you so much, Comrade Amechi Asuguna, NLC Deputy President. Thank you for your time.
God bless.
We hope there won't be protests.
We hope the action will not affect us too.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Hello. Hope you enjoyed the news. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification button so you get notified about fresh news updates.